are some exceptions to words ending easy. And these are the major exceptions. Impressionism, materialism, metabolism, professionalism. Don't forget, others have the primary stress on the first syllable, as I've said earlier. Most of the words that end in ish, that ish, are stressed on the syllable that comes before the syllable ish, ish. For example, we have rubbish. See where the stress is. Rubbish. We have flourish. We have establish. Establish. We have outlandish. We have punish. We have furnish. And we have brutish. See where the stress is before the ish syllable. That is where we have the stress. Please take note. No matter how long the word is, the stress, the primary stress must come before the ish. Most syllabic words that end with the suffixes ious, yes, graphy, graphy, eous, eos, ivy, have the primary stress on the last syllable of the stem, that is the base or the root word. For example, we have suffix ious, prestige, prestige. Don't forget what I said the other time. It's not prestige, prestige. Now we have prestigious, prestigious. Then you have injury, becoming injurious, injurious, injurious. We have melody, becoming melodious, melodious. We have photo, we have photo. You know, I told you the other time, not for photo. Now we have photography, photography. We have porno, porno, becoming pornography. We have typo, typo, becoming typography. We have confirm here, becoming confirmative. Please take note of this, these three words, the last three words. Confirmative. Then we have super, superlative. And of course, we have compare, comparative. Most polysyllabic words that end with the suffixes ious, graphy, eous, ive, have the primary stress on the last syllable of the stem, that is the base or the root word. For example, we have suffix here. Look at this word, prestige. We have two syllables here, prestige. Press teach, and according to what is on the chalkboard, the stress come on the last one. That's why we have this on TI here, becoming prestigious, prestigious, because we say the stress is on the last syllable of the stem, and this is the last syllable of stem, two syllable here. For emphasis, please take note. We have, this is the root word, prestige, and it has two syllables, press and t, press and t, and that's why the stress is on the t here, as you can see, prestigious, prestigious. Now the same goes for the other words here, and I want you to look at the ive, the first one under the ive. We have confirm. Confirm has two syllables as well. Confirm. Confirm. And the stress must be on the last syllable of the stem. And that's why we have confirmative. 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 And others. Look at this.
when a verb of two-syllable word ends in A-T-E, the second syllable receives the primary stress. E.g., you have berate, you have relate, you have frustrate, we have dictate, we have predate, we have locate, we have sedate. Look at it. The first one here has two syllables. Berate, berate. And we have the last one, which is the second syllable, stressed. Relate, two syllables. You can what applies to these two applies to other words here. The first one is written in small letter, while the second one is written in capital letter, which means it is stressed. The last syllable is stressed. Berate, relate, frustrate, dictate, predate, locate, sedate. So these are the words and some other words, of course, when it is a verb and it ends in A-T-E, know that the last two, syllable is stressed. Two words, not three. In our last lesson, we had a look at a primary stress. But here we have something different, that is still a stress, emphatic stress. In sentences, there are times when a particular word will be stressed above others. When this happens, the word is meant to pass a specific message across to the listener or reader. Such a word is said to be weightier than others in the sentence. In a sentence where we have such stressed words, they are usually boldly written or written in blank forms. That is the word that is emphasized in the sentence. When you come across a word that is boldly written or a word that is written in capital letter, in this context, it is referred to as the emphasized word. And we'll see how we deal with it as we continue. Consider a situation in which a sentence is written and has a word in capital letters. The emphatically stressed word. The word that is written in capital letter is said to be emphatically written. It's supposed to be emphatically written and emphatically stressed. So it means it has a message to pass across to you. So the sentence can be a declarative or an indicative one, but certainly not an interrogative statement. My father lives in Lagos. My father lives in Lagos. You know, Lagos is emphatically stressed, and that is why it is written in capital letters. Now, the possible questions that can be asked from the given sentence, that is, with interrogative sentences, include, I've given you three here. Does your father live in Lagos? Does your mother live in Abuja? Does your father live in Abuja? Take note of those three interrogative sentences. From the given sentence, don't forget this one up here. The word Lagos is stressed. So, the opinion C, which states a place different from Lagos, that is stating a contrary place, is the answer. So please take note. Here you have Lagos. It is not Abuja, but where? In Lagos. So that's why the correct answer here is Lagos. It's C.
You can ask me, why? This one also has Abuja. But we are not talking of mother, so we are talking of father. So that's why C, option C, is the correct answer to that. This type of stress is used to serve as contrast. Now you look at the emphatically stressed word, then you look at the one that contrasts or that serves as the opposite or that's against it, so to say, then that happens to be the answer. Hence, it is also known as a contrastive stress. It contrasts the emphatically stressed word, Lagos here. So we want to give more examples. Once again, are you going to know the correct answer among the given options? Look, the first thing you have to do is to look at the word that is emphatically stressed. And that is the word that will attract your attention. It's not in. It is not leaves. It is not father. And it's not my. But the one that that is emphatically stressed. Therefore, for you to know the correct answer, you look through the options. And the one that this one up here, the statement answers. Or in other words, when you look at the question here, the one that this one answers exactly is the one that is the correct answer. Look at the first one. Does your father live in Lagos? We are talking of Lagos. That's not the correct answer. Does your mother live in Abuja? It is true that Abuja is here, but we are not talking of the mother. We are talking of the father. It is the only Lagos here that is the strongest word according to that statement. And that one attracts your attention. Then you look for the last one. Does your father live in Abuja? So we pick this one. This one is my father lives in Abuja, is answering. This is the question. And this one is answering the question. And not this one, and not this one. And indeed, that's the reason why I said the other time that it is a contrastive, because Abuja here is, in terms of a place, it is different from Lagos. It is different from Lagos. It's very easy to know. In fact, it's the simplest aspect of stress. Because you first of all look at the word that is capitally written. That's number one. Then number two, you look at the questions asked. You definitely come across one that is against this capitally written word, as we have it here. This Lagos. And it's not in Lagos. My father does not live in Lagos. Sorry, my father does not live in Abuja. He lives where? In Lagos. So it's very easy to know. And we want to see more example of this. Because we may still make this one distressed word. We may make this one distressed word. It depends on how the question is stressed. Or the question is asked. Please take note. But we have seen the first one. We are going to give two or three more examples. Now let us examine and consider more examples of emphatic or contrastive stress in different sentence stresses and point out the central drive or point. Example one. Now this is broken into three. It's a Ruth scrubs the floor daily. Ruth scrubs the floor daily. Look at A. Ruth is given emphatic stress. In other words, Ruth is emphatically stressed. Now we have Ruth scrubs the floor daily. This means that it is Ruth, not any other person, not even Aminat or Peter or whoever, that does the scrubbing daily, but who? Ruth. So it is this Ruth that will catch your attention. It is rude that we catch your attention. And then for you to know the correct interrogative statement there, that this one will be answering, it means we are going to look for the one that looks like the opposite or negative to this root. And that's why we call it contrastive. The one that contrasts with the root should be the answer. Not scrubs. You forget about the scrubs. You forget about the floor and you forget about the daily. Just concentrate on root. So that will give you the correct answer. For instance, I may say, does Shola, does Cordelia strops the floor daily? Of course, it's not Cordelia. It is who now? Who that does it? So it is the one that looks like the opposite of what you have here. Emphatically stressed. Now that's one part to the sentence. Another part of the sentence B. Ruth scrubs the floor daily. It is not Ruth here that received the emphatic stress, but rather it is scrubs. And it is this one that will certainly attract your attention when you are looking for the correct answer in the options. All right. They say this means that the floor is scrubbed, not swept, and not dried. So take note, it is this one that will attract your attention, and by the time you are looking for the correct options, you look for the one that talks about sweeping, or talks about drying, or any other form different from scrubs, and that will serve as your correct answer in the competing options. Then we have the third one, which is C here. Ruth scrubs the floor daily. Ruth scrubs the floor daily. Now, daily is the word in the sentence that is emphatically stressed. And it's not a matter of weekly. It's not weekly. It's not monthly. It's not even bi-monthly. It's not yearly. So if you come across any option that talks about weekly or whatever, now it's against this daily. Therefore, that one will be the correct answer. So please take note. You see, this means that she does it daily, not weekly, not always, not monthly, and in fact, not yearly, but daily. So you shouldn't forget the fact that the emphatically stressed word is the word that captures or that must capture your attention, that will be that you attract your attention for you to get the correct answer. Once you do that, then the answer becomes obvious. The answer becomes obvious once you have taken note of the emphatically stressed word in the sentence. It is as simple as ABC. So that is what you mean by emphatic stress. You know, it's quite different from the primary stress where you have a particular syllable. It's not a matter of syllable, it's a matter of word. It's a matter of word in a given sentence. So please take note. It's very simple. Very, very simple. And you can't miss it. Once you can identify the emphatically stressed word in that sentence, then the answer becomes very obvious and very simple. Thank you.